नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विथ माय लव एंड रिस्पेक्ट्स। आई वेलकम एवरीवन सिटिंग विद अस थ्रू Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, Ara TV and two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha all over the world. City is sitting with us, having Nayana Deeksha all over the world. Kuala Lumpur, Austin, Toronto, Phoenix, Seattle, Los Angeles, St. Louis, Ohio, Suva, Fiji, Melbourne, Tiruvarur, Mill Valley, Koolim, Tiruthani, Tiruvanmiyur, Wilmington, North Carolina, Guadalupe, Seattle, Minot, North Dakota, Houston, Dakota Dunes, Hyderabad Guptakashi, Hong Kong, Charlotte, China, Singapore, New York, Varanasi, Maurice Plains, Calgary, Amarnath, Madurai, Rajapalayam, Vancouver, Doncaster, UK, and Dubai, London, Kosice, lot more cities are joining. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, 8th day of the Rajarajeshwari Brahmotsavam, Devi is gracing on Ashwavagana, horse vehicle. Much to say. Today, as part of the Rajarajeshwari Brahmotsavam, Devi's 10-day celebration, eighth day Ratotsavam of Devi Rajarajeshwari happening, and March 2nd, each one is receiving their karma and fruits of their karma back. What goes round comes back. And I don't need to expand much on it. The life and the incidences happening are explaining the truth. Falsehood does not stand the test of time. Only truth can stand the test of time. Much of you guys are next generation, so you may not even be aware. It's an age-old method. Attacking Hinduism constantly. It's time we wake up. We wake up. We wake up. At least protect ourselves. With this, I'll enter into the satsang. Today, I'll enter into the fifth verse of Isavasya Upanishad. Please recite along with me. Taddejati. Tannai jati. Taddure. Tatvandike. Tadantarasya. Sarvasya. Tatu sarvasyasya. Bahyataha. Please recite once more. Tatejati. Tannejati. Taddure. Tadvandike. Tadantarasya. Sarvasya. Tatu sarvasyasya. Bahyataha. The translation is, that moves and that moves not, that is far off, that is also near, that is the inner space of all this, and that is also the outer space of all this. Now, through this statement, Upanishad is declaring, you need manana, internalizing, to experience consciousness. Not just shravana is enough. Shravana, listening, to instigate manana, internalizing. Please understand. The fifth verse also again describes the various qualities of consciousness, or I can say the various techniques with which you can move yourself towards the consciousness. You can experience consciousness. Tadde jati, tannai jati, taddure, tadvantike, tadantarasya, sarvasya, tadu sarvasyasya, bahyataha. Tadde jati, tanne jati, taddure, tadvantike. That moves and that moves not. That is far off. That is also near. That's the inner space of all this. That is also the outer space of all this. Listen. Seemingly confusing description. But the most clear statement ever uttered on the planet Earth is this statement. Most authentic statement ever uttered on the planet Earth is this statement. Tadde jati, tannai jati, taddure, tadvantike, tadantarasya sarvasya, tadu sarvasyasya bahyataha. Discovering your consciousness experientially is the purpose of your life. Understand, I am not using the word inventing. I am just saying discovering. Discovering your consciousness is the purpose of life. Whether you lived as a spiritual being, you lived as a cook, lawyer, engineer, doctor, professional are not doing anything, nothing counts. Whether you lived as a political leader or social leader, nothing counts in the cosmos, understand? The only thing that counts in the cosmos, have you discovered your pure consciousness? The good news I have is, nothing what you considered as a goal of your life, whether you achieved it or not achieved it, is considered as goal at all in the cosmos. If you think you have not got the good name in your neighborhood, don't worry. It is not the goal of the life. If you think you don't have this, you don't have that, don't worry. This is not the goal of the life. People who have all those wasted their time and energy. The one and only goal, please understand, I am not saying this goal is the first priority of the life. No, this is the only goal of life. The only goal of life is discovering your pure consciousness. Every moment you spent in discovering your consciousness, you used that moment in your life. Every moment you did not spend on this goal, you wasted those moments in your life. I'll give you one small tip. Whenever you are able to think, internalize with the goal of reaching your source, all those moments are meditation. Even if your thinking looks very confusing. See the yesterday's Vakyartha Sadas of kids. It is thoroughly confusing. And I wanted to tell you, all the statements they said is lie. All the statement, nothing is true. And nothing is false. I don't want to say whatever they said is false. I only want to say everything is lie. Lie is not false. Sometime, lie is a name of the in-between stop between the truth and reality. When you are lying down during your journey between truth and reality, it can be called as lie, but it's not false. Understand, whatever they said is lie, but that does not mean they wasted their time. No. They are moving towards the reality. Whatever they said is not false. It's neither true nor false. It's a beautiful practice through which they are moving towards the reality. That is why I am encouraging Vakyartha Sadas continuously. Listen. I also wanted to use this moment to congratulate our Yuva Sangha youth group. They again started the Vakyartha Sadas. I'm so happy they are doing it through internet and Skype call. Same way I wanted all over the world, Sangha should actively engage yourself in Vakyartha Sadas. Please understand, only time you spend in Vakyartha Sadas is the time you chisel yourself. You discover your consciousness. your quality of integrity, quality of authenticity, quality of responsibility, quality of enriching will just multiply million times, billion times if you can spend little time on Vakyartha Sadas on every day. Because many times, internalizing of these great truths, you may not be able to do it sitting alone. Because the fourth block, fifth block you reach, in your mind you will collapse and fall asleep. And may want to have a sip of Coca-Cola, coffee, one phone call to your friend or to your buddy, over, your Vakyartha Sadas ended. Your manana ended. But if you have as a team and do the Vakyartha Sadas, you will dedicate certain amount of time just for this. At least for the sake of engaging yourself in the conversation, you will think every subtle nuances, aspects of these great truths. So again and again and again, I insist on Vakyartha Sadas. Vakyartha Sadas is directly doing puja to consciousness. The time you spend on Vakyartha Sadas is direct manasa puja. So the amount of time I used to spend in Vakyartha Sadas when I was young, and the time I will take to travel to those sannyasis and seekers and satsanga, sometimes I will walk even 2 hours to reach the places where sadhus are staying to have Vakyartha Sadas. Sit with them, listen to them, talk to them. Almost every day, from the house to Annamalai Swami's ashram, I'll walk. In those days, there was no other mode of transportation. Of course, cycle, two-wheeler, everything was available, but I can't drive any of that. That is different. I didn't know. For quite a long time, I can't balance the bicycle. Only very recently, I managed to balance bicycle. And so, because that right, left, that balance was never in the cognition. Never I felt right and left as a two separate entities which I can balance. Anyhow, that's totally different context, different understanding. Listen. But I never felt that Annamalai Swami's ashram was too far away. Friend's house is never far away, because when you are going, you are in the memory of, you are in the mood of spending time with him. It will never be far off. You will be just seeing. Suddenly it is there. And I tell you, Vakyartha Sadas will help you guys to discover many of the truths on your own. On your own. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure, tadvantike, tadantarasya sarvasya, tadusarvasyasya bahyataha. That moves and that moves not. That is far off and that is also near. That's the inner space of all this, and that is also the outer space of all this. This is consciousness declaring about itself. Understand? This is God introducing about himself. Who is the source of the whole cosmos, is introducing about himself in this verse. तद्दे जति तन्नै जति तद्दूरे तद्वंतिके दट मूव्स एंड दट मूव्स नॉट दट इज फार ऑफ दट इज आल्सो नियर दट्स द इनर स्पेस ऑफ ऑल दिस दट इज आल्सो द आउटर स्पेस ऑफ ऑल दिस मीन्स that moves consciousness tadde jati and tannai jati that does not move in riddles the upanishads are declaring the ultimate about the ultimate in riddles in paradox in the words which is apparently confusing chaotic tadde jati tannai jati that moves and that moves not how to understand it means they are saying sit and contemplate what is the meaning of that moves and that does not move what should be that What is it moves and does not move? Array, what is this? Already I have too many problems, questions. Why should I think about all this? No. You have to. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure, tadvantike. Understand. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure, tadvantike. I'll repeat the meaning. That moves and that moves not. That is far off. That is also near. How can something be far off and be near? That's the inner space of all this. That is also the outer space of all this. Brahmanda and Pindanda. Brahmanda is the outer space of all this. Pindanda is the inner space of all this. It is that and it is this. Today, Upanishads speak in riddles, in paradox, utterly confusing. That's the right word I'll use. Utterly confusing. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure, tadvantike. तत् अंतरस्य सर्वस्य तदुसर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः इफ यू जस्ट इंट्रानलाइज अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन वर्स यू विल बिकम एनलाइटेंड वाक्यार्थ सदस शुड बी द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिस इन ऑल अवर गुरुकुल्स एंड ओल्ड एज होम्स बिकॉज वाक्यार्थ सदस इज द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिस Even the elderly people can do. Sit and internalize, intranalize. What is it that moves and that does not move? That's far off, that is also near. Mahadeva is describing about himself. Understand? You can never understand him with your logic. Only he can introduce himself to you. Here he is introducing himself. That moves not, that is far off, that is also near. That's the inner space of all this, that is also the outer space of all this. Tadejati tanai jati tadure tadvantike. Mahadeva is introducing about himself. He is not just giving you his visiting card. He is just describing about himself. Contemplate on it. He is describing about himself. Contemplate on it. He is the inner space of all this. He is also the outer space of all this. Actually, if you contemplate on these verses, you will achieve complete brahmacharya, because these verses are so powerful. They will just open up your whole kundalini shakti. Brahmacharya is all about opening up kundalini shakti. If your kundalini shakti is opened up, you will achieve brahmacharya just like that. So simple. In a most simple way. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure tatvantike. Tadantarasya sarvasya tadusarvasyasya bahyataha. That moves and that moves not, that is far off, that is also near. That's the inner space of all this. That is also the outer space of all this. Actually, you can't comment on it. I can't expand on it. How will I expand? I can only go on repeating till you catch it. Meaning of this verse. Is that strange smile I am radiating when I am uttering this verse, it is hidden in that smile. It is hidden in my eyes, which is smiling when I am uttering these words. I can't do anything other than carrying a strange smile in my lips and the eyes when I am uttering these words. More than that, no commentary can be written on it. No explanation can be given to it. I am only sitting and enjoying. You fellows need this. Contemplate on it. Internalize it. Meditate on it. You did not do when you were young, nah? Come on, do now. That is what exactly the meaning of that smile. I tell you, discovering the consciousness is only purpose of life. Whether life puts you in heaven or life puts you in hell, the only message life wants to send it to you is discover your consciousness. Whether it gives you whatever you want and keeps you in the highest pedestal of the world, society, money, wealth, power, name and fame, everything is offered to you. The life is sending you the message, discover your consciousness, which is beyond all this. If you are tortured, pushed into poverty, no food, disease, no medical care, you are literally stinking and dying every moment, life is sending you the message, discover your consciousness. That's the only way to be rid of this. Understand, whether you are showered everything or tortured every moment, the one and only message life is sending to you is discover your consciousness. Whether it is March 2nd or March 3rd, March 3rd is Jivan Mukti Jayanti. Understand, whether it is March 2nd or March 3rd, March 2nd is attack. March 3rd is Jivan Mukti delivered. Both have the same message. Discover your consciousness. I take that also as a message from life, consciousness. Discover your consciousness more and more. Help people to discover their consciousness more and more. Jivan Mukti Jayanti. Again, this is the message. Discover your consciousness. Tomorrow is one of the greatest book ever written on the planet Earth. One of the greatest book ever revealed on the planet Earth. Jivan Mukti is born. I would have written so many, I may continue to write so many, but Jivan Mukti is Jivan Mukti. That book is that book. Tadejati, Tanaijati, Tature, Tadvantike. Meditate again and again. Internalize. Do Vakyartha Sadas today on this one phrase. Tadejati, Tanaijati. That moves and that moves not. That's all. Do Vakyartha Sadas just on this. You will understand. You will understand deeper and deeper and deeper truths. I'll see to it everyone discovers consciousness. With this, I bless you all. Let everyone radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 0802727999 www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation